or who knows how long. Nobody said a word. The fact that Sayaka and Junko were dead was a huge shock, of course. There was more to it than that. It was also the idea that one of us had actually murdered someone. Well, murdered Sayaka. We all saw Monokuma murder Junko. We all saw that. If we didn't find out who it was, we would all die here. We found ourselves in a situation where we couldn't help but look at each other with open suspicion. It was the worst situation imaginable. Wait until they find out she's dead in your room, dude. It's gonna look hella sus on you. And yet, even in such a perversely terrible situation, she didn't show the slightest hint that it had gotten to her. Hey. Now no time to wallow in your depression. The worst thing we could do right now is lose all faith in each other. That would lead to the same disastrous result as having total faith in everyone else. What? The fuck you just say?
In other words,
cooperation is absolutely key at this point. If you decide to trust or not trust, of course, it's up to you. Continuing to think about and talk about the disease certainly isn't going to help anything.
What the heck?
Saying stuff like that is just... How many times have I told you, anyone who can't adapt will die? Death is only waiting those who are unable or unwilling to adapt. And if that happens, you only have yourself to blame.
That's terrible!
What an awful thing to say, especially after what happened.
Just a second.
Right now, exposing the killer is the most important thing. Because if we don't, we're all going to die here. She's right. Besides being the cold-hearted bitch and all, she's right. We need to begin our search right away.
Of course.
Either way, we can't run away from the situation, so we have no choice but to move forward.
What the heck?
We just have to do it, I guess. Okay, guys, we're gonna do it. We're gonna do it. Keep pumping yourself up. Let's do it. What other choice do we have? No way in hell am I letting someone kill me. Fuck it. I'll kill someone before they kill me. Alright, damn it. Let's do this. We just have to do it. I won't keep repeating that sentiment. They're using it like a mantra to give themselves strength. But they're right. We just have to do this. No matter how much we don't want to, we have no choice. Okay, guys. Come on. We're talking about doing it. Now let's go do it. Stop talking about doing it. Let's go actually do it. If that's what it takes to survive, then that's what we have to do. On top of that, there was something I needed to find out. And I had to know why Sayaka had to die. Why she had to be the one. I'm terrified to find out, but still, I have to know. Otherwise, I knew I'd never be able to accept her death. Which is why I don't have any choice. I have to do this. Hi, guys. There's still Juko's body right here. Then I placed my hand on Juko's lifeless body. I touched her wrist to check for a pulse, but like they do movie stuff. But. Nah, bitch. She just got impaled like 6 or 7 times. She dead is dead. She really is dead. Wasn't anything else to say. She was gone. I don't know why you even bothered to check. After those injuries, only that much blood. Really, I'd be shocked if she did survive something like that. Hold on. Hold on. Wait a second. She's dead? Then that means... What? I mean, everything that's happened so far is real. It's not a joke or whatever. It's real. Oh my god. Hero. Hero. Hell no, someone save me. Let me out of here. Somebody help me.
What's your problem?
You're just now accepting that?
Do I have to talk to everyone?
Sure, hi Kyoko. You're the one standing directly in front of me. I guess I'll ask you stuff. Before we start searching for Sayaka's killer, we need to decide what to do about securing the crime scene. What do you mean? You're thinking of putting someone on guard duty so nobody can disturb the area, aren't you? After all, if the culprit decides to destroy the evidence, we're pretty much screwed. As if they didn't destroy the evidence after they committed the murder, right?
Hey!
In that case, I don't mind doing it. I don't like having to think anyway. I'll let you guys figure out who killed that chick. Okay, then we can let Mondo look after the scene. No, we can't just leave him there alone. What? Why the hell not? Isn't it obvious? If you were the culprit, what's the first thing you would do? If Once you've got your position, do all the evidence you want. Fuck you!
So then.
Fine, then I'll stay there and guard you as well. That way there's no problem. Team player, come up there. Base defense with the two of them. With their stats, they're totally OP. Oh my god. Why, Hafumi? Why? Since we will be able to help investigate, we're putting our faith in the rest of you. I'm still pretty freaked out, but I'll try. Can I leave?
Just a second.
Hold on. Before we begin investigating, is there something else we need to discuss? What do you mean there's something else I need to discuss? You want me to talk to everyone? I talk, how you holding up? If we find out who did it, then only that person dies. But if we get it wrong, then all the rest of us face execution. That's what the ridiculous school regularly says. So stupid. Yeah, I don't know why I'm helping you. You need to hurry up and figure out who the culprit is. Yeah, thank you guys. So we're really gonna try to find out who did it?
Oh.
So you finally noticed. Noticed what? I was looking through the Monokuma file we received, and I noticed something very obvious and very unusual. What are you talking about? Go ahead, take a look. Notice anything about where Sayaka died? He died in Makoto's dorm. Well, there you go. There you fucking go. Everyone can look at Makoto now. Look, he's right. Could it be? All ones of the one case turned to me. Yep. Hold on a second, you got it all wrong. There's one night I traded rooms with her. That'd be good, she was afraid. You expect us to believe that? Just tell us the truth. I look in everyone's eyes, just had done a split 180 just a few minutes earlier. Feeling suspicion and fear had returned. In other words, you think I did it? He thought to himself. Are we all done talking? We need to begin our investigation shoot. At this point, we should split up. We need to get to the bottom of this and find out who killed Sayaka. Please form a foundation, then construct an argument to come to a final decision. If we get this wrong, well, do I really have to say anymore? I'd rather you didn't know. Everyone pray for good luck. Yeah, I'm the ultimate lucky guy. And of course, the first murder is the person I let stay in my room. So she idiotically let someone into her in my room. And then they killed her. Okay. I'll be going too. Just like that, you would never realize. Yeah. Oh yeah, I'm on guard duty, huh? I better head to the scene of the crime. Oh, that's right. Let me just say this right now. Whatever son of a bitch did this is here right now, and they're thinking of destroying that evidence.
You're fucking dead.
I better not let me find them. I'll skip the trial, okay, of their goddamn school and myself. Okay, that is murder. Mondo, murdering someone is gonna get you executed if we find out it's you. I know you already have anger issues, but no. Bad Mondo. I'm serious, I will fuck them up. And his other word hanging here, yes, Sakura ran off. Well, I mean, we're not detectives or anything, you know? Are we gonna investigate a murder? How do we even do something like that?
Anyway.
We don't really have to do anything in particular. We already know who kills that. What are you implying? Damn, Toko. You're not gonna give me benefit of the doubt? How would I benefit from killing someone in my room? How does that benefit me? It was you. I'm telling you, it wasn't me. Don't come any closer, you gotta kill me. God, that freaking animation. Are you gonna kill me next? I guess I want her to give it a shot. Not for sure that Makoto's guilty, yeah. That's true, we may as well at least check, just to check. Even if I wanted to, I couldn't help investigate. Wait, why not? I'm not good with blood. I'll take his long limbs and I black out.
Oh, yeah.
Like you did when Jungo was murdered in front of us. And you didn't black out or anything. Got it. Well, whatever, I don't think anyone was expecting much from you anyway. Alright, I guess I better get going. Wait, don't you get it? You have to hear me out. Oh, with violence, everyone had already left. Spider-Man looked at me, had filled with suspicion. Does everyone really think I'm the killer? I didn't turn out like this. Seriously, they got it all wrong. Why do they have to suspect me? Do something. Otherwise, everyone will. Yeah, good.
Execution! Electric chair! Poison gas! Torn apart!
Yeah, we get it. I can't let that happen. I can't let things turn out the way Monica wants. All I have to do is find out who really did it. Who really killed Sayaka. I guess I should look for the Monica file we got before. The victim was Sayaka Maizono. Time of death is estimated to be around 1:30 a.m. So, we were sleeping, right? We had to get Monica out of the room in the dormitory. All evidence suggested that death took place in the bathroom. The death was a stab wound to the abdomen. There was also an injury to her right wrist. Specifically, the wrist appeared to have suffered a fracture. We chose to push forward, but we want to find out what happened. Let's find the truth. All we can see. Five for Sayaka. I have to find out how she was killed. God, I can't. Nice. Monica Mofile 1 has been added to your truth bullet section to your handbook. So everyone went to investigate except Hiro and Chihiro. We have two heroes here. And a dead Junko. How you holding up, Hiro?
No way! I seriously hurt. I seriously don't want to die here. I'm begging you, God, Buddha, Mother Earth, the God of Space, King Neptune, help me! I don't care who it is, just get me out of here.
Hiro doesn't seem to be prepared to do any kind of investigation right now. Yeah, Hiro is just gonna be useless, probably.
Aren't you going to help investigate Hiro?
But I can't leave Junko here, I feel sorry for her. I have to stay with her. Oh, Chihiro. Alright, guys. Yeah, first of all, I should head to the scene of the crime in my room. We won't make any progress without investigating there. So I'm in my room where side course still. I'll examine the state of my room a little closer. I might reveal something new. Take a look at some of this shit here. This is a replica sword I brought back for self-defense. That Sayaka told me to bring back for self-defense. Does it mean it was used in the tax amount? And plus, taken out of a sheath. I haven't actually looked at the blade itself, so now I shouldn't be surprised it's coated in gold, too. On top of that, some of the gold coating has come off on parts of the blade and the handle. Yeah, the handle especially is missing a lot of its coating. I remember the coating stick to you even if you just touch it a little bit. Nice. There are scratches and gouges on my walls and bed. Is that evidence of a struggle? There must have been some kind of fight in my room. Damn it, I was right there in the other room if only I heard something.
Wait.
That would have not been possible. Huh? Don't you remember? All our rooms are completely soundproof. So something could have happened in a room right next to you and there's no way you could know. Perhaps this was another Monokuma strategy creating an ideal setting for murder. Evidence of a struggle had been added to the truth bullets. Sheath. This is a replica sword brought back for something. Doesn't mean it was used in the tax amount. Plus the sword had been taken out, so it's just a sheath, but. Huh? There's some scratches on the sheath that must have been made with something sharp. But how did the sheath get scratched up in the first place? Even if someone used a sword during the struggle, it doesn't make sense for the sheath to be damaged. If you're gonna attack someone with a sword, the first thing you do is unsheath it. A heavy sheet like them will only get in the way, it could just slide off in the middle of the fight. Why there's scratch marks? Good question, Makoto. There are guys in the bed like someone attacked it. What the hell happened here? Not like the lawn, well, it looks like there was way less than there was before. Did I see how dirty my room was and decide to clean up a little? Here. The key on the ground has my name on it, this must be my room, if I remember correctly. Oh, that's right, we'll have to trade keys. When we switch room, we switch keys too, so I would have had the key here in my room the entire time. What if that's true, then? How did the killer get in my room in the first place? Could say I could have forgotten to lock the door? No, that seems impossible. The thing goes for you a second, no matter who it is, don't open your door for anyone. You're not sure, see, I absolutely won't open it. Otherwise, what's the point of even switching? After saying that, there's no way she would have forgotten to lock it or open it for any reason. Maybe she dropped the key somewhere and someone else got it. No, that's not possible either. when we switched room. How scared she was, she wouldn't have gone walking around. She'd have dropped it. Oh, Kyoko's here too. Hi, Kyoko. Suspicion of Zorbazon. Hi, Sakura. Do you think I'm guilty too?
Hey.
I shot to make assumptions like that. I simply don't know whether or not you did this. Whatever the rest of you come up with, I will follow you. But you'll give me some benefit of the doubt. There are scratches and gouges on my walls and bed. Is that evidence of a struggle? Looks like there must have been some kind of fight in my room. Our rooms are pretty bad. Remember? Blah, blah, blah. I had the discussion. Hey, Mondo.
By the way.
You know, I realized something that while I was in guard duty. The killer could have already destroyed some evidence, right? Before anyone even found the body, I mean. The trash room here in the dorms, right? They could have tossed some stuff in there. Yeah, that's definitely possible.
You son of a bitch!
That dirty bastard! Anyone who raised their hand to a woman is scum that deserves death. That's why my brother. That's what my brother taught me.
You're fucking dead.
Whoever finds that son of a bitch that did this, I'm gonna pound his goddamn face in. But what if it was a girl that did it? Mondo's like, the fuck?
Yo.
That'll all get sorted out when the time comes. My notepad. I'm about to tell you, but I don't think it's relevant right now. Yeah. So this has, I don't see any evidence when you, which makes sense, I guess. It's mine. I haven't had it. I can't imagine where I need to record like this.
Yo.
Yeah, seriously. Oh, Mondo.
What? What?
We ain't exactly in the mood to be building the fucking furniture, right? So you haven't used yours either then?
What?
Not just me. Nobody busted it out yet, as far as I know. Anything we were telling you about it yesterday.
By the way.
None of the guys have opened their toolkits yet, because, like, why the hell would we? Hey, Kyoko. Hey, Kyoko. I don't know why she was investigating the area, but...
What are you doing? Isn't it obvious?
I mean, it looks like you're pointing at the floor, but...
No, not really. I'm searching.
It kind of looks like a fucking... Like... I don't know, like a child or like a puppy or something that's just very amazed at what Kyoko's doing. Like, whoa. It's like, yes, I see.
Searching?
She was down on her knees, carefully inspecting every inch of my room.
Did you lose a contact or something?
Shut the fuck up. I don't know what she's doing, guys, but she seems to crunch pretty hard on it. What if you think she said?
Listen.
Are you a clean freak? No, I don't think so, but what the... Actually, you guys around my room one more time.
I see.
Interesting. What's interesting?
Hey.
Just as I suspected, there's something very unusual about your room. Unusual? What do you mean?
So...
I searched your room from one corner to another. I didn't find one single strand of hair. Really?
Indeed.
Not one hair from the victim and not one hair from you, even though you've been living in here. Now that you mentioned, I noticed something while I was looking around too. It looked like the lint roller in my room had been used, but I never touched it. Could someone have used it
too? I see.
Very interesting. Your room didn't have a single hair in it, and someone used your lint roller without your knowledge. And then otherwise, someone other than you came in and scrubbed your room clean. Was it Sayaka or the killer?
Well?
That's the question, isn't it? Got his room clean. I suppose that's... I guess we gotta go in the bathroom now. Check out Sayaka's body. On the other side of that door. No, I can't let it get to me. I can't afford to freeze up now. Force myself to push my panic and I step to the bathroom. Sayaka! My assistant! Looking at her made it painfully clear it wasn't a dream or an illusion. She had lost everything that made her, her. Sayaka. All at once I was overcome with dizziness, nausea, the urge to burst into tears. But I can't hesitate now. Why? Why does Sayaka have to die? I have to uncover the truth. I have to find out what happened. I wanted to give up. I wanted to collapse, but the thought held me up and supported me. I guess there's only two things to search. I told myself I had some grin face when I saw, but now's no time to think like that. Although the monocle failed to verify what it said about her body. Some sort of sharp object been thrust in her stomach. That must have been the killing blow. Whatever used to kill her, where'd they get it? Definitely something I should look into later. Also, according to Monokuma's file, Sayaka's right wrist is broken. Her wrist does look swollen and bloody, and that's for sure. But there's some sort of glittery thing on there. Right there, where her wrist is all swollen, there's something glittery. That definitely concerns me. So you think she was holding the sword by chance? So maybe the killer came in, was getting ready to attack. She grabs the sword for self-defense. Maybe blocked it with a sheath first, and that's why there's cuts on the sheath. And then pulled it out, tried swinging, missed. Somehow in that corrosion, broke her wrist. And ran to the bathroom. I think that concerns me. There's some blood on her left index finger, but that's it. Oh, both of her hands are totally spotless, so how come on her left finger? Sayaka's wrist has been added to your truth bullets. The stab wound in her stomach is what killed her, so when she broke her wrist, that must have happened early on. I mean, how would her wrist get broken after she'd already been killed? So it's very possible she broke her wrist during the struggle. The killer attacked Sayaka's main room, which is when her wrist got broken. That killer cornered her in the bathroom. So they inflicted the deadly wound. Oh, so dramatic. And then there's... I looked past Sayaka at the wall behind her, and then I saw... Huh? Written below where the number is 1-1-0-3-7. I mean... There's a little scratch mark right there, which makes me think maybe that's not a 1, that's an N. If you look at it, what is it spelled Leon? I think it spells Leon. Wait. Isn't Leon... baseball dude? Is it Leon? Or is someone framing? I mean, it's in her blood, and I'm guessing because of her index finger, it's got blood on it. So what? She wrote Leon's name? Never mind. Japanese characters writing name in English, but interesting, huh? Sayaka do this? God, that makes it uneasy.
It would seem...
It looks like you found it, right, Makoto? The bloody numbers, that's most likely Sayaka's dying message. I'm gonna go dying message. What do you mean by dying message?
So...
Something to victimize before they die. Yeah, I know what they mean. Usually that's the way to tell people who killed them. And whenever... Whoever writes it doesn't make it totally obvious, so the other writer is somewhere that the killer wouldn't notice written in code. So. Wow, that's pretty incredible.
Hey.
Have you heard of Ellery Queen? Who?
Whew.
Never mind. Kyoko's annoyed. Wrong button. I think I've explored everything. I'm gonna talk to Kyoko before I leave. Let's have another check. I saw the bloody numbers in the bathroom. Yeah, okay. I've seen something written in blood before. It really was her final message. That if she wrote it with her life itself. Do you often talk like an inspiring poet? But the number she wrote, what do they mean? 11,037. I have no idea what that could possibly
mean. So...
The way she wrote the numbers made me think she wanted to use her body to block them. She wrote them in that location while she was sitting that way when we found her. It means she must have wrote them by turning only her hand towards the wall. If you were to write something in that position, do you know what the result would be?
Well,
think about it. You're not going to tell me.
Makoto.
You need to uncover the mystery of this case yourself, otherwise the case will end and you'll remain unconvinced. I have no idea what you're trying to say, Kyoko, but it's obviously not going to tell me. Dying message. Yeah, but... Kyoko knows what Sayaka's dying message means, but honestly, I have no idea. Oh, I know who I should talk to when it comes to numbers. You better ask in the ultimate program. And only one other thing I wanted to ask you about. You know how the door to your bathroom got broken? Broken? What do you mean by how it gets stuck?
What?
Gets stuck? Yeah, I guess I'm the only one, but the door doesn't fit in the frame quite right. When I first tried to use it, I thought it was just locked, but once you learn the trick, it's over, no problem.
Correct.
So the door doesn't quite fit the frame, huh? But actually, I'm referring to the broken doorknob. The doorknob?
That's right.
You didn't notice? Well, just start closing the bathroom. I'm sure you'll see right away what I'm talking about. Like what Kyoka said and shut the bathroom door. Damn, my doorknob busted. Someone fucked with my doorknob. The doorknob? What the heck? My doorknob probably about to fall off. Why is it like this?
It would seem...
So I must have used a screwdriver or something similar to unscrew it. Whatever it was, it's obvious that it was intentional. What? It was intentional? Why would someone want to do that?
So...
I guess maybe they're trying to get the door unlocked and ended up breaking the whole thing. But my bathroom door doesn't have a lock on it. Only girls' bathroom can lock, right? She stood there for a while, lost in thought. I'm struggling with certain relationships. She's got a question to me.
Just a second.
I have just one more question for you. You mentioned earlier that your bathroom door would get stuck, right? Did you tell anyone about that? I did tell Sayaka about it last night when we switched rooms. So what you're saying is only you and Sayaka knew about it.
Mm-hmm.
Interesting. She had the slightest hint of a smirk on her face. You could sense she was really starting to get into all
this. I see.
And that clears that up. Oh, what clears what? I'm so lost. Yoko, what aren't you telling me?
Goodbye.
I'll see you later. And forgetting I was ever even there, she suddenly turned and left the room. I don't understand any of this, but I've already given my room a good once over. Maybe I should go look around elsewhere. I started looking into where the murder weapon might have come from. And also, I should look into the DVD Sayaka got. Sayaka did, I have no choice but to see myself in that video. On top of that, I'm sure there are some other areas worth checking out too. Maybe I should see what everyone else thinks, if they'll even talk to me, that is. Guys, I didn't do it, I promise.